Yeah, how are things going, Codemaster, by the way? School started, right?
I am your
I think most schools have started by now. I think it seemed like this. I only want to keep one of the one drops. Get straight to the things better. If it's Zoo, I don't think it's Zoo. And then we'll keep Twilight Drake against other control warlocks. Bone Mare. Turns out Bone Mare is a really good free to play card. So it pretty much goes in every deck that you're going to do free to play. Can you stay with Stonehill Defender? I think you play that in every deck too.
Hey G Winner, welcome to the stream. That's up Tuesday, it's still Friday over here.
Oh yeah, it's Friday over here too. Alright. I'm gonna just tap. And save point for later on. So I get the biggest drakes possible. You guys have any plans for the weekend? So we could have only tapped because we played Mistress on turn 1. Usually if you have a coin, you can't leave tap. Whoa, he actually chooses to play Felgar instead. So he should be another Blood Reaper Gul'dan deck, but I don't think this is a good card for him. Why would you run this? You'd rather discover it through Stonehill Defender. Okay, so let's draw first, and then we'll play another big boy Drake.
Hey, Linhos, welcome to the stream. My boy Lock Shadow. Only a fool
rejects a lich king. It's not really efficient to clear this off. Then we use the stone health to try to clean off the line shoulder. I have so many 7 drops I'm probably gonna play. Maybe just go with the reserve. These decks run Twisting Nether or not. Willingly run Felguard past rank 20. It's actually not bad. Like, I sometimes will discover the Felguard instead of taking Senjin, for example. Because it is a demon and you can get revived. That's why. Alright. We're gonna go in his face then. Or we can Hellfire or like this, but I put there's a board. I think I like boning his face better.
I was watching your last YouTube video, now you are restreaming. Nice.
Welcome to the stream. Glad you found it. And yeah, I know in the YouTube I couldn't like say have fixed streaming schedule, but it's good you caught me live too. And this is with the updated version of the deck, so that's good. We bone him again.
Bone after bone.
So yeah, this one's updated with the Twilight Drakes and the Bone Mares, which are better against control. And I feel like I haven't faced as much aggro these days. It's like a lot more control decks. Man, we almost have lethal. Wait, we do have lethal because of the Hellfire. Because I was going to be like, we need one more turn before we get coin. Board.
It's good, man.
Like, I don't know why he's playing his version of the deck. Honestly, just play my version. My version is so much better than whatever shit. Whatever the heck his deck is. Like Shadow Bolts, the Drain Soul stuff, those are all kind of meh cards.
Rank 8 only with this deck?
Yeah, pretty much. Because this is like the deck I really enjoy playing right now. And that's what I've been playing on this server. Will you be playing Exodia Mage? No, probably not. Exodia Mage, you can watch like Dog plays a lot of Exodia Mage. Your soul shall be mine. I kinda wanna do something different from other streamers right now. Which is nobody is streaming free-to-play decks, really. Like, you can see all the cool, well, I don't want to say it's cool, but, like, it is cool, but sometimes it's also Resident Sleeper, like the Fatigue Warrior and stuff. You can watch other streamers play that. They'll play it better than I can, because I haven't really practiced it. It's because this is more, rogue is more like a, depends on what kind of rogue, I guess there's a lot of jade rogues, but it's not aggro, I don't think it's an aggro rogue, so I didn't have to coin out Cabal Courier and then play a 3, like even though I have 2 3s, I guess it is aggro. We can clear if we want, just do this, Mistress of the Pile, but I think I can be greedier, right? So let's go with Earthen. Earthen trades with the 3-3. Where are you from? I'm currently in California. Northern California. What's the top 2 Death Knight heroes in your opinion? Well, the easiest ones to put in are like the Druid ones. You just pretty much toss it in. It's pretty easy. You don't have to do anything with synergy. The Priest one is very strong. What else is strong? Let me make this play. I think I'm gonna go with Dreadlord. Okay, we got Dreadlord after power. Yeah, the mage one, I feel like it's redundant. Like, why is Jaina, the mage one, better than just say play Priest Mage? Like, what is so good about that compared to Freeze Mage or Burn Mage? Doesn't it just do a better job? Like, play Alexstrasza instead of Jaina. So some things don't really make that much sense to me. It's like, you're trying to find a reason or an excuse to put it in. In that case, do you have the Hunter of Death Knight? The zombies are really fun. Yeah, Hunter one is another one that you can do free to play, but I haven't unpacked it yet on any server. Yeah, so I'd have to craft it. Is it possible to get a job in UA as a foreigner? You mean USA? Yeah, it should be. But I'm not the right person to ask about this. I don't really know the procedure. I guess I have to do this and coil and then this guy. I don't get to draw the coil, but I set up a minion. I heal. And get ready to bone him. This is a strange deck. It's got pirates, it's got elemental. Blood and plunder. More pirates.
The Brotherhood shall prevail.
Okay. So we can do silence. Wait a second, let me catch my breath. Yeah, I think we do silence. Remind so we play this first and then silence. Greater healing potion. Then we just take Glimmer Roots. Seems good.
Your magic shall not save you.
Hey Taho, good to see you. How's your week going? Don't you think Acolyte Pain could be replaced with something more useful since you already got card draw with your power? Yeah, you say that, but then you'll appreciate those times when you have to use the file as a board clear. And then, if you combo it with Acolyte, like I think Acolyte is fine as a 1-up. Maybe 2-up is not necessary. But against aggro, you might even want more acolytes. Honestly, it's like pretty, it's a pretty good card against aggro. So we have this. We just want to bone something big, right? Once we bone something big, then we're good to go. I think they run sap though. Sap or the wild spine. Okay. So we can do defile and then bone him. And then he shouldn't be able to top deck anything that kills us. Think of Acolyte Defile combo. Yeah. It's a pretty sick combo. Especially against like shamans or token stuff. You clear the entire board, you draw three cards. Pretty insane. So there are definitely combos with it. It's kind of the same with a Tainted Zealot. Like you can combo a Tainted Zealot, but I'm not sure about running two of them. So that's why there's one of Acolyte and one of Tainted Zealot. The initial list I ran had two Acolytes. They even had Loot Hoarders. Yeah, Omaha value. Bone Mare. It's actually a really good card. It puts a lot of pressure on. 7 mana, 9/9 worth of stats. And half of those stats gets charged, essentially. Pretty good. Hellfire, we think it's aggro. But I think most likely it's Jade stuff. Which I guess Hellfire still needs to be against Jade because they developed their early Jades. Thoughts on Taunt Druid. Taunt Druid is it weaker or stronger than Jade Druid? Depends. You can definitely out-tempo Jade Druid, and then you can buff up your taunts, and you can win that way, because Jade Druid is super slow. So I initially just say it probably has an advantage over Jade, but of course if you don't get those taunts out, and then they get to generate bigger and bigger Jades, you'll lose in the long run. That card's legit. MVP for free-to-play players, this expansion. Yeah, at least Blizzard gave them something, you know? They made a lot of cool cards, epics, but at least Bone Mare. It's really good for arena, it's really good for free to play stuff. Five AM here. Where is it? 5 AM. You guys are in Central or like in Europe. This is like the same time as like Netherlands and stuff. Famous. Assuming he's like big druid. Big druid. I think you might be able to steal something useful.
Hey Apex! Lockshop stream is my birthday. Happy birthday, Apex. Hey Shadowwater, welcome to the stream.
Or Shadow Eater, sorry, not Water. Shadow Eater, welcome to the stream. I'm doing well, how are you? Hope you're having a good night. Dipsosaurus? Portugal? Okay, yes. Yeah, basically along the same area.
Right, welcome to the stream. Did you get to this rank with only this deck?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, sometimes I have to do other quests, but the actual serious climbing is with this deck. I've kind of been lazy about getting legend these days. I'm a little bit tempted to try to hit legend with this deck this season. I think it'd be pretty cool to show that, you know, free to play still exists. The cool thing is we don't really spam the board with a lot of minions, so the unleash the taunts doesn't really affect us that much. about to get Bone back. Maybe not Bone, Siphon. This guy's running out of steam. Actually, his birthday is next month. It isn't my birthday, it just feels nice, you're lying. Aw, thanks Apex. Yes sir, you got my name correct. It's been a rough week. Channel member is in the hospital. Question mark. Sorry to hear that. I hope your channel member recovers quickly. And I hope you're also able to go there and spend some time with them too. Okay, Gloomeroot. I think we play the strongest minions. So Gloomeroot, Verdant, and Wutan. And then we can bone. Alright. It's gotta be Savage Roar or Mark, I guess. I don't really care about Savage Roar. I'd rather have the Mark of the Lotus. So let's just pick this because I want this card. Ah, nice. Okay. Savage Roar is—it's a possible card in their deck, but it's possible it's only a one of. Like if I make the deck, I would only put in a one of. Not two of them. But I would definitely put in two Mark of the Lotus. Mark of the Low Tide, maybe. This game is to be pay to win?
Yeah.
Rip Blizzard. Let's just bone him. Let's just go face.
Side effects? No.
Can we?
Trust me.
It's okay to face. How do we get punished? Like, he has to tank some damage like this, right? Maybe he has silence? Silence and Savage Roar is still. And Hero Power, that's still one off lethal. How's this deck do against J-Druid? It's been seeing a lot of those. You basically need to out-tempo them. You're not gonna win in the long game. Although in the YouTube video we did win one in like the heat game, but that's not typical. So you basically want to out-tempo them, get your big minions, bone them in the face, and just even Blood Reaver cooldown. They don't have good board clear, so you know they're gonna have trouble when you play Blood Reaver cooldown as well. But if they get the ramp, like they get all the ramp and they can play the big stuff, yeah, it's pretty hard. GG easy.